For the past 15 years, I've been traveling and giving speeches about the digital health revolution. And wherever I go, I keep hearing the same fears and criticisms against it. A big part of the medical community simply doesn't want to embrace something like AI, as they feel that their job as physicians and their value as a diagnostician will be in danger. They tell me that technology takes away the art of medicine. But it's a flawed mindset. And I would like to use a documentary, AlphaGo, to prove to you that the art of medicine is not going to vanish. In fact, it's only getting started.
That could extend the power of your mind. Virtual environments and games. We think they're the perfect platform for developing and testing AI algorithms. Games are very convenient in that a lot of them have scores, so it's very easy to measure incremental progress. So I'm going to show you a few videos of the agent system, the AI. So let's start off with Breakout. So here you control the bat and ball, and you're trying to break through this rainbow-colored wall. The agent system has to learn everything for itself, just from the raw pixels, doesn't know what it's controlling, doesn't even know what the object of the game is. Now, at the beginning, after 100 games, you can see the agent is not very good. It's missing the ball most of the time, but it's starting to get the hang of the idea that the bat should go towards the ball. Now, after 300 games, it's about as good as any human can play this and pretty much gets the ball back every time. We thought, well, that's pretty cool, but we left the system playing for another 200 games. And it did this amazing thing. It found the optimal strategy was to dig a tunnel around the side and put the ball around the back of the wall. The researchers working on this, amazing AI developers, but they're not so good at Breakout. And they didn't know about that strategy, so they learned something from their own system, which is pretty funny and quite instructive, I think, about the potential for general AI.
The Chinese game Go is one of the most complex games ever invented. Unlike chess, where at any given moment in the game, the number of moves is about 20, on a 19x90 Go board, it's 200. And the number of possible configurations on the board is more than the number of atoms in the universe. So, if the victory of IBM's Deep Blue over Garry Kasparov in 1997 was huge, then a win from Google DeepMind's AlphaGo over the 18x Go world champion Lee Sedol would be, I don't even know the word, is gargantuan. Because winning in Go requires more than computational power. It needs creativity and intuition, human skills that many believe are beyond current artificial intelligence technology.
여전히 자신감은 있는 상태고요. 아무래도 역시 아직은 인간의 직관력이나 이런 감각들을 컴퓨터인 인공지능이 따라오기에는 약간 무리가 있지 않나 이렇게 생각을 해서 제가 꼭 인간의 그런 걸 지켜낼 수 있도록 최선을 다하겠습니다.
So the year is 2016 and Lee Sedol is preparing to sit down for the first time against AlphaGo. Almost 80 million people watched their match, and before it began, almost everyone expected an easy win from Sedol. But the machine beat him. The world champion was visibly shaken. How did it happen? Easy. AlphaGo didn't learn to play a game like others before it. The machine that beat Kasparov learned everything from how humans play chess. AlphaGo uses something called reinforcement learning. It played against itself millions of times in hours, and then were told which outcomes were positive until it could anticipate its own moves and how those moves would affect the game's outcome. Sedol and AlphaGo played four more times against each other, and AlphaGo won three of those. And for example, in game two, AlphaGo made moves that left experts wonder.
AlphaGo는 비실은 뭐 확률적 계산을 하고 그냥 이기기 위한 그런 머신에 불과하다고 생각을 했었는데 그 수를 보는 순간 아니구나. 충분히 AlphaGo도 창의적이다. 아, 정말 아름답고 바둑의 그런 아름다움을 잘 표현한 수고 굉장히 창의적인 수였다.
Over the long course of its evolution, humanity has accrued beliefs and mechanisms by which it views and understands its surroundings. Artificial intelligence will not be burdened by these preconceptions, and AlphaGo were able to surprise everyone with a move that nobody else thought of. That's because the advantage of reinforcement learning is that the cognitive limitation or the learning curves of humans are not built into its algorithm. So it didn't inherit the boundaries and flaws of human intelligence. It was free to find new and exciting ways to beat the game, things we wouldn't even think of. So what was the beaten champion's takeaway? First, Saddle was disappointed and embarrassed. Just imagine how it must have been. His ego was shattered, his whole existence as an undisputed champion came into question. He had to play Go like it was his first time. He faced moves no human opponents would have played. And most importantly, he felt like he's representing all humans in a losing battle against something otherworldly. It's understandable too. A superior AI will always feel weird, but it also has the potential to be the most revolutionary creation in human history. And by game 5, Saddle had a newfound understanding of what AlphaGo is and who he is.
이번 경험을 통해서 조금 더 성숙했다고 생각하기 때문에 그걸 정리 잘해서 앞으로 또 발전할 수 있도록 하겠습니다. 정말 내 바둑 두는 이유를 찾았다라는 느낌. 사람들이 이렇게
He started to analyze the new ways AlphaGo found to play this game. And by doing that, he became a better player. And that's exactly how the medical community should look at digital health revolution as a whole.
He improved through this machine. His humanness was expanded after playing this inanimate creation. And the hope is that that machine, and in particular the technologies behind it, can have the same effect with all of us.
I remember hearing a talk by Kasparov, who says that a good human plus a machine is the best combination.
AI is not going to replace us. It's going to be the stethoscope of the 21st century. Digital health will give us more health data than ever before, and AI will help us analyze it to find new ways to treat diseases, but ultimately, they are going to be tools in the hands of physicians. And they will help us find new and exciting ways to beat deadly diseases and make our lives better. As I said before, if we embrace these tools, the real art of medicine only begins now.